Well, come with me, y'all. My name's Rick. When you are on drugs and alcohol, this is a deal with you making for death. You never go back to.
I won't pretend to know what you're thinking, and I can't begin to know what you're going through.
I met this place 5-6 years ago. My buddy Billy lived back here. I think he was a resident back here about 6 years. This is Billy's house. This is where he was, he was murdered here.
This is my house.
This is what I dwell in. A lot of lonely souls have gathered around here and, had to create havoc. This is where I lay. This is a pretty serious matter here. This is not made for anybody. But when you do a contract, you pick up that dollar a year, $250, whatever it may be. This is the price you pay.
And this is called desperate addiction. When they go in the dollar store and steal things like this or buy things like that for a meal to get high.
And I won't deny the pain that you're feeling.
I'll see you.
But I'm gonna try and give it all up to you.
Guy had
called
me dinner, like, we're drinking here.
Yeah. Okay. And due to the relapse, they felt at the moment I'm not suitable to be there. Hopefully, once again, to see some clarity of the seriousness of alcoholism. Alcohol takes away your thinking abilities, your talking abilities. It leaves you look like you're tired all day long. My goal is to achieve some sobriety.
Just remember what I told you. There's so much you're living for.
Hi, my name's Rick Chen, and I'm here at the Wilson House. This is basically like a phase two for me. My third phase, of course, would be my establish my own apartment, keep in touch with my church. And I've came a little ways from that garage to the Wilson House. Get myself a little stronger, like I said, keep my sobriety, keep in tune with my Lord Jesus Christ, which is my ability to stay sober. Without Jesus Christ, I cannot stay sober. I can take you up to the loft. The loft is basically a relapse issue. If you relapse, this is where you wind up. Usually you get a room first try, but if you relapse, you get the loft. That's me, which I'm happy to be here. It's a little, it's not arranged very nicely, but there's a bunch of guys here that you gotta understand that. This is a place where you can take hold of your own self, do your own thing, handle your own affairs. If you fall, that's the way it is. I mean, they ain't gonna buy babies yet.
There's a light at the end of this tunnel. There's a light at the end of this tunnel for you.
Trigger that you can have if you have a chemical dependency. These are all triggers. Faces, smells, things. These are all triggers. And that's what brings me on to my drinking binges. The Budweiser lights, the activity of the people. You get to know the people around real well, what their activities are, if they're prostitutes, if they're drug dealers, if they're users. You can manipulate and con and baffle your way into money. So everything is a tool with this disease.
You got your disappointments and sorrows, and you ought to share the weight of that load with me. Then you will find out the light of tomorrow. A new life for your eyes to see. So remember what I told you. There's so much you're living for. There's a light at the end of this tunnel. There's a light at the end of this tunnel for you. For you, yeah. There's a light at the end of this tunnel shining bright.
There's a church where they can enable you. You know you're being fed on a Saturday. You know you're being fed on a Tuesday. You know you can go for groceries on a Wednesday. Sometimes you've got to take action yourself to make things right, because we have to ask Jesus Christ to come into our life and give us that direction.
There's a light at the end of this tunnel, shining bright at the end of this tunnel for you.
When you are on drugs and alcohol, this is a deal that you make with the devil that you can never go back to.
So remember what I told you. There's so much you're living for. There's a light at the end of this tunnel. There's a light at the end of this tunnel for you.